Our next fight is something, and it's happening outside of the women's flyweight division. And I say that because both these women unranked, and they've been on the cusp before. Montana De La Rosa has had a number next to her name in the past. But we have De La Rosa taking on the Queen of Violence, Arianny Lipsky. And Matt, when I look at this fight, both fighters are very similar at just about every aspect. Now, for Lipsky, we were sold a bill of goods coming into the UFC, former KSW champ. Is this the second coming of Karolina Kovalkiewicz? No, it was not. You look at it for Lipsky so far in the UFC, 2-3. I mean, she lost to Joanne Calderwood, who, okay, she's up there. Lost to Molly McCann. All right, it's going to happen. Beats Isabella De Padua, who came in on short notice, and that fight was closer than you probably wanted out of a Lipsky fight. She then goes on to beat Luana Carolina in one of the most disgusting submissions you've seen in a while, at least I know I have. And then she loses to Antonina Shevchenko. But here's the thing. She didn't lose to Antonina Shevchenko because Shevchenko outstruck her. She lost to Antonina Shevchenko on the mat. She was held down for most of the first round. She was held down for the second round. She ends up getting finished. She ends up getting TKO'd. And it was a bit of a soft call by old King of Violence, Chris Tyone. But still, she got totally mopped by Antonina Shevchenko. All right, we throw it on over to Montana De La Rosa. You know that she's accredited in terms of jiu-jitsu. Both these women are. She was an All-American and state champ at high school wrestling, but it still counts for something. And you know that that's her bread and butter. Because for Montana De La Rosa, maybe not the most comfortable striker, I'll say, to be polite. I think that's polite. I don't mean any slight by it. But when I look at this fight for De La Rosa, definitely has fought quite a high level of competition. Maybe she has lost some of those fights. But I don't mind a draw to Maeda Buena Silva in her last time out. I mean, the losses, Viviane Araújo, Andrea Lee, she beat Mara Romero Barella, who is a training partner of Arianny Lipsky at American Top Team. And then again, the other win, Nadia Kasem. But then you look at the other wins, Matt. Rachel Ostovich, Christina Marks, it's tricky.
Both of these fighters are in the same boat. These are two fighters who don't have a quality win on their record yet. Because here's the thing. For all the decent fighters that Montana De La Rosa has fought, she hasn't beaten any of them. She might have been somewhat competitive in some of those fights, but you kind of know what you're going to get from Montana De La Rosa. She's going to spam takedown attempts, and she's going to spam takedown attempts. And that's really just the bread and butter to her game. She's not much of a striker, like you would say. Kind of awkward on the feet. Very stiff, kind of, but not like the Dan Henderson way, where he's got a lot of power if he does hit you. In the, like, hey, Randy Marcos, you probably shouldn't strike kind of way. It's just with Montana De La Rosa, it's really tough, especially at this division, the 125 pounds women division, to be so one-dimensional. Because you look at the top of the division, listen, we can make fun of Caitlin Chookagian, but guess what? She's gotten a lot better throughout her UFC career. And what's she good at? She can strike at range, and she's really, really good at that. She's really hard to get taken down, it's really hard to take her down. And she has great takedowns herself. She's good at a lot of different things. Montana De La Rosa really only brings the wrestling aspect of her game into the cage with her. And that's why I really struggle to pick Montana De La Rosa versus any other well-rounded MMA fighter. But when I look at Arianny Lipsky, she kind of reminds me of when Rudy Gay went to the Raptors. Now listen, I love the Toronto Raptors probably more than I should. When Rudy Gay went there, I was told, hey, Rudy Gay, he averages like 18 a game. That's really good. Like, you know, numbers are good. And back then, I didn't know nearly as much as I know of basketball. So I just looked at 18 points per game and thought, hey, that's really good. And with a record of 13-6, you're like, hey, she's not bad. Queen of Violence, good nickname. There's going to be a really cool backstory to it. Not really. She's a fighter who gets taken down quite a bit. Has decent striking, but when I look at Lipsky, it's not like her striking is good enough to really go out there and get the knockout. Like, I can't rely on Lipsky, who, even if her opponent can't strike at all, I can't really rely on Lipsky to outstrike them. So, in my mind, I just see a world where Montana De La Rosa turns this into a wrestling match, and I don't know how Arianny Lipsky can win that version of this fight.
It is a really, really tricky fight. I mean, when you do look at it in terms of the odds, this is where it scares me a bit. De La Rosa minus 140 at open. She's now minus 225 favorite, or sorry, 265. She's the biggest mover and shaker on this card, which is kind of crazy to think of. At about a 47% clip, it's De La Rosa and Dolidze, the two biggest movers and shakers. For Lipsky, open a plus 120. She's a plus 213 underdog. If we have a look at the Tapology votes, 1,344, 64% Lipsky to 36% De La Rosa. And again, not the greatest of records. And yeah, both women have losses to good fighters. So that's a really tricky thing. Who's looked better in losses? Well, De La Rosa didn't look great against Araújo, and Lipsky didn't look good against Shevchenko. We can just keep going on and on. It is a really tricky fight. I could see this one going either way. So at the end of the day, who are you going with?
I've got Montana De La Rosa strictly because I do think that this fight is only going to come down to the wrestling. And Montana De La Rosa is one of the better pure wrestlers in this division. She's not the best. She might not even be top three. But she's a decent wrestler for the flyweight division. So I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, Montana De La Rosa, she's going to 30-25 Ariane Lipsky. And then she's going to call out Jessica Andrade. Nothing crazy like that. But I do think she will be able to wrestle her way to a win.
It's a bit of a salty 4-2. 1-1 in the UFC for De La Rosa. Again, 2-3 for Lipsky so far. You look at the quality of gyms, Elevation Fight Team for De La Rosa. You look at it for Lipsky, training out of American Top Team with women that are on this card. Specifically, you've got Marina Moros, but also Romero Barella, who is in her corner. You know, a little bit of consistency or familiarity there. And Janaysia Maranjan as well. So an interesting look from Lipsky. If you like her, let us know down below in the comments section. But Matt, I'm in agreement here. I've got Montana De La Rosa, although I wouldn't be putting any of my hard-earned money on this one. You can laugh about that, but it is a tricky fight. We're both going with Arlington, Texas's Montana De La Rosa. Matt, absolutely love this card. We have two big heavyweight fights up at the top. You've got Harris taking on Tybura. You got Sakai taking on Rosa Strikes. Keep it locked in with Fight Night Picks, as we always say. Let's get into it.